Good morning, students. Yesterday, I explained about preparation of ethers by using alcohol. How to convert alcohol into ethers, I explained. When you take primary alcohol and heat with concentrated sulfuric acid at about 140 degrees Celsius or below 150 degrees Celsius, then it undergoes dehydration to form ether. If it is a secondary alcohol, tertiary alcohol, that undergoes dehydration to produce alkene, but you don't get ethers. Okay. Next, one of the important methods in preparation of ethers is Williamson's ether synthesis. Williamson's ether synthesis. Now see here, by Williamson method, yes, we can prepare ether, but which type of ethers we can prepare? So as yesterday, means in the last video, I explained how to get there is a ether from alcohols by using what primary alcohol, and secondary tertiary cannot give what ethers. And there I told conversion of alcohol into simple ether, alcohol into simple ether. It means both side. Yet means across that oxygen, left side, right side, there is R group and both are same. That is called symmetrical. But today I will tell you symmetrical and unsymmetrical ether preparation by using what? Williamson's method. Now in this method, see here, alkyl halide is taken. Alkyl halide RX plus R dash O NA. R dash O NA. This is called sodium alkoxide. Sodium alkoxide. This one alkyl halide. Alkyl halide, sodium alkoxide. On heating, they react each other to form R O R dash plus Na X plus Na X. Now R O R dash components are said to be ethers. R O R dash components are called ethers. Now when R and R dash groups are same, like light methyl methyl, ethyl ethyl, there we get same methyl O methyl group, ethyl oxygen ethyl group, like this. So by writing here what same alkyl groups, we get simple ether. Different alkyl groups, one side methyl, other side ethyl, one side benzene ring, other side what ethyl group, methyl group, or here actually benzene ring and here methyl ethyl groups. But all those reactions we can study. But this equation, it is a general equation for Williamson's ether synthesis. It is a general equation. Write general equation for the what preparation of ethers by Williamson's ether synthesis method or Williamson's reaction. Okay. Now take here alkyl halides, but preferably here primary alkyl halide. This is fixed. Methyl ethyl we can use, but not isopropyl group, tertiary butyl group. Okay, reasons I'll tell you why we are not using secondary tertiary and only primary. Primary halide is fixed in what Williamson method. But here we can write any group, primary, secondary, tertiary, and even aromatic group like phenyl or benzene ring. And to get what ethers, means by using same alkyl groups, we get simple ether. Different alkyl groups, what mixed ether or unsymmetrical ether. But this method mainly applicable to prepare mixed ethers. It is applicable mainly to prepare mixed ether or unsymmetrical ether. Unsymmetrical ether. Now we'll study some examples under this. Okay. But how to define Williamson reaction or Williamson ether synthesis? Definition: alkyl halide reacts with sodium alkoxide. Sodium alkoxide to form ether. This is called Williamson ether synthesis and is mainly applicable to prepare mixed ethers or unsymmetrical ether. But even we can apply this method to prepare simple ethers. But mixed ethers are obtained by this method only. And from what alcohol or by using dry silver oxide. Alcohol or by dry silver oxide, yes, we can prepare only that simple ether or what symmetrical ether. Next. Examples, CH3, CH2Br. This is called bromoethane or ethyl bromide. It's alkyl halide part written, 1 degree alkyl halide. CH2Br is said to be here, 1 degree. Plus CH3, CH2, ONA. ONA. Now see here, CBr bond, negative, positive. It is a polar bond. Delta minus delta plus. Next, RO minus alkoxide ion, and this negative part attacks on the C plus. But it is stronger than Br minus. Therefore, what the reaction in which weaker nucleophile displaces stronger nucleophile. Weaker nucleophile displaces stronger nucleophile. It is called nucleophilic substitution reaction. It is also one of the nucleophilic substitution reaction, because stronger nucleophile displaces weaker nucleophile. Negative part of this sodium alkoxide, yes, attacks on the C plus, then the CBr bond break. Next we get NaBr, then this one connected to O. CH3, CH2, O, CH2, CH3. Therefore we get a product CH3, CH2, O, CH2, CH3 plus NaBr. CH3, CH2, O, CH2, CH3. CH3, CH2, O, CH2, CH3. And this molecule named as ethoxyethane or ethoxyethane or diethyl ether. It is called diethyl ether. Okay. How do you convert bromoethane to ethoxyethane? And write the equation. This is the question. Yes, write equation like this. And first molecule, bromoethane. Second molecule, sodium ethoxide. Sodium ethoxide. It can give ethoxyethane or diethyl ether. So this reaction is said to be a symmetrical ether preparation. Symmetrical ether. But we use Rx and R-ONA. Or Rx and Rx, RONA. Therefore, this reaction named as Williamson's ether synthesis. Next, for mixed ethers, see how we can use chemicals here, alkyl halide and sodium alkoxide. Mixed ethers. Preparation of mixed ethers. Example 2. Now consider we want to prepare CH3, CH2, O, CH3. Here ethyl methyl ether. Next, other example, CH3, O, CH3. First molecule ethyl methyl ether, mixed ether. Second molecule tertiary butyl methyl ether. In the nomenclature, in the last class, I told about nomenclature. Here numbering 1, 2, 3. Second position, alkoxy group. 2-methoxy-2-methylpropane. 2-methoxy-2-methylpropane. Or common name, tertiary butyl methyl ether. This compound. But these are said to what? Unsymmetrical ether or mixed ethers. See how to prepare these. And here, fill in the blank. And right here, alkyl halide, and here, sodium alkoxide. But which alkyl halide you have to use? Today, I told one special point by Williamson method. Yes, we have to use only primary alkyl halides. or alkaloid which contain less number of carbons. And CR before the O, 2 carbon, after the O, 1 carbon. Therefore lower carbon is methyl. Therefore alkyl halide should be methyl halide, and methyl halide may be CH3Br, CH3Cl, CH3I. So better you take methyl bromide or even methyl iodide. Methyl iodide is more reactive than methyl bromide. Next, second compound. See here, it is a mixed ether, and you have to think Williamson's reaction. In Williamson reaction, Rx plus R dash ONA. But I have written here Rx. Then R dash ONA is R dash ONA. But R dash equal to CH3CH2. This is R dash. R dash. ONA. ONA. By heating sodium ethoxide and methyl bromide, but don't write ethyl bromide and sodium methoxide, that reactivity very low. But this is preferred because alkaloids should be what, or alkyl groups should be smaller than what sodium alkoxide group. Therefore, these two react, NaBr and CH3O, CH2, CH3, CH3O, CH2, CH3. Yes, this is the answer. By mixing sodium ethoxide and methyl bromide, yes, we get compound methoxyethane or ethyl methyl ether. Even in competitive exams, they can ask to prepare this compound, which of the following set of compounds are used? Yes, first one, methyl bromide. Second, this one. And so two compounds are given in option one. Option two, first here, ethyl bromide, sodium methoxide. And third, both are correct. Means whatever one and two compounds are given, they are correct. And last, none of these. So the most accurate means correct answer is which one? Methyl bromide is alkyl halide which contain lower number of carbon. That is correct answer. Next, here also same type. This one, tertiary butyl group, methyl group. Again, smaller group, methyl. And is methyl group is very next or before the primary group, CH2 group. Therefore, third example, CH3Br or CH3I, CH3Cl. Next, CH3C, CH3CH3, Rx plus R dash ONA, ONA, R dash ONA, sodium tertiary butoxide, sodium tertiary butoxide, and this is methyl bromide or bromomethane. Again, same type, O minus goes to C plus and Br minus goes to Na plus. Instead, it is again nucleophilic substitution. Nucleophilic substitution. Then we get product, yes, tertiary butyl group first, then O links with CH3. But don't write this here. And if you write this one here, what happened? We'll discuss later. Yes, this is a method how to convert methyl bromide into what? A mixed ether. Now, how to define? Methyl bromide react with sodium tertiary butoxide to form tertiary butyl methyl ether, or 1, 2, 3. 2 methoxy, 2 methyl. 2 methoxy, 2 methyl propane. 2 methoxy, 2 methyl propane. Okay. But this compound name, T butyl methyl ether, it is common name, IPCM I told. Now, simple ether I told first by using ethyl bromide and sodium ethoxide. Second, mixed ether, methyl bromide and sodium ethoxide. Third, also mixed ether, methyl bromide, sodium tertiary butoxide. Next, special point regarding this. If you interchange, what happen? Take this here and this one here. Means tertiary butyl group here and methyl group here. See, what is the what reaction? But here I told substitution occur, correct? It is said to be nucleophilic substitution reaction, and also it follows SN2 mechanism. Even in the last class or in the last video, I used this word, there is ascent to mechanism. And in the ascent to mechanism, stable transition state is formed. If there is a formation of a transition state, then only we can say that undergoes ascent to mechanism. If you get stable carbocation, then it is said to be SN1 mechanism. Now see how it can follow SN2 mechanism. SN2. Now see here, methyl bromide, we can write like this. Methyl bromide, partially breaking the bond here. Next, O C. This is called transition state. We get the transition state C link with 3H and two groups opposite. Bulky groups are opposite side. And now it is possible, it is stable. Okay, that's why this is called a nucleophilic situation reaction. So when it attacks on the C, then CBr bond break, then we get ROR. Then it is said to be nucleophilic. When this Br is replaced by C4SNN group, OC4SNN group, then it is said to be nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay. This is in what? SN2. It is called SN2 mechanism. Okay. There is no formation of stable carbocation. Hence you have to say it is SN2 mechanism. Next. Now consider this one here. CS3CBr. When you take tertiary alkyl halide, Rx equal to this one. If you take this one and see what happened. CS3ONA. Now you can expect same product here, this and this. NaBr is removed and COCS3. But you don't get. This compound not obtained. Okay. Because in haloalkane topic I told which haloalkane is said to be what more reactive. Primary, secondary, tertiary. Tertiary halides are most reactive. But here, this is called tertiary halide, most reactive, and that can undergo easily dehydrohalogenation. They undergo easy dehydrohalogenation because RO minus means alkoxide ion. Not only it is said to be nucleophile, but it is also said to be a strong base. And it can cause dehydrohalogenation of this alkyl halide, means in presence of sodium methoxide, tertiary butyl bromide undergoes dehydrohalogenation like this. CH2H, H plus Br minus removed, and this bond shift, H plus and alpha beta, beta H removed. If beta H is removed, then we get alkene, therefore. CS3C double bond CH2 CH3 plus NaBr plus HO, therefore methanol plus NaBr. No, actually this reaction occur if you take tertiary halide. That's why I told to prepare ethers by Williamson method, you have to use only primary alkyl halide here. Primary alkyl halide, ethyl bromide, methyl bromide, propyl bromide. But best is methyl ethyl, because if size increases, again reactivity decreases. Okay. And this undergoes SN2 mechanism. It follows SN2 mechanism. Okay. When tertiary butyl bromide is heated with sodium methoxide, undergoes dehydrohalogenation to form alkene, that is 2-methyl propane. 2 methyl propane is obtained. You don't get ether, you get alkene 2 methyl propane. That's why very carefully you have to answer to prepare what unsymmetrical ethers. So remember one point, which one? Alkyl halide should be primary alkyl halide, and that must contain lower number of carbons. Lower number of carbons. Next, this I told using alkyl halides, how to prepare simple ether, mixed ether. And even we can prepare aromatic ether like anisole. Preparation of anisole. Fourth example. Example 4. Preparation of anisole or aromatic ether. Aromatic ether. To prepare aromatic ether, yes. In place of RONA, now we take. Yes, this compound, yes, we can prepare from phenol. So this I told 3-4 times regarding the salt, sodium phenoxide. Sodium phenoxide is the salt of phenol. It is obtained by mixing phenol and NaOH. When you mix phenol with sodium hydroxide, then we get sodium phenate. This is called sodium phenate or sodium phenoxide. Plus alkyl halide CH3I RX plus RONA RX plus RONA. Again, it is called Williamson method. Means even Williamson method extended up to preparation of aromatic ethers. Even aromatic ethers are obtained by Williamson method. Then we get a product. See here, O negative goes to C positive. Then I minus and Na plus come into form NaI. Therefore, methyl plus O negative equal to OCH3 bond. Then we get. OCH3 plus sodium iodide. This is called methoxy benzene or anisole. Product is methoxybenzene or anisole. Explain the preparation of anisole by Williamson's method. This is called Williamson method because alkyl halide and aryl oxy, sodium aryl oxy or sodium alkoxide. But here instead of alkoxide, aryl oxy, we can use aryl oxy. Now we can prepare what? Aromatic ethers by Williamson's method. Next, one more point here. Why to use ring ONA? Why not CS3 ONA? If you use CS3 ONA, what happen? Now, reverse it. Benzene ring I plus CS3 ONA. Aryl iodide plus sodium methoxide. But you can guess product is ring OCS3. Same. But you don't get ring OCS. Means you don't get any sol. If you use halobenzene, chlorobenzene, bromobenzene, iodobenzene with sodium methoxide. Because in case of haloarenes, haloalkanes, haloarenes, there I told halogen atom which contain 3 lone pairs and is undergoing delocalization with the pi electrons of the ring and undergoes partial double bond character. Means it has a partial double bond character. And this bond cannot be easily broken. And you don't get ring OCS3. No. Means in case of halorine, halogen atom has partial double bond character due to resonance. And then they are strongly held or tightly held with the aromatic ring. And that Cl atom or X atom cannot be easily replaced by nucleophile such as methoxide, ethoxide, etc. If you take here ethoxide, yes, no, we cannot prepare, but here we can change. Here C2S5I plus sodium phenoxide gives phenetol. There is ethoxy benzene is obtained by changing here, not here, because this one cannot react with the sodium methoxide to give what, NSOL or phenetol. So remember, sodium phenoxide can be used to prepare aromatic ether, but not sodium alkoxide. Sodium alkoxide, okay. This is Williamson's ether synthesis. So I'll repeat once again about Williamson's ether synthesis. It is one of the important reaction. Alkyl halide react with sodium alkoxide to form ether. The reaction is said to be Williamson's ether synthesis. It is mainly applicable to prepare unsymmetrical ethers or mixed ethers. Then we can also prepare by this method simple ether. But mixed ethers which contain tertiary group or tertiary alkyl group, but that should be obtained from, that group should be obtained from what, sodium alkoxide, not from what, alkyl halide. And alkyl group from alkyl halide should be smaller. Means the primary halides are used in what, Williamson's ether synthesis. Okay. And to prepare aromatic ethers, you have to use sodium phenoxide or sodium phenate. Sodium phenoxide or sodium phenate and alkyl halide, methyl bromide, ethyl iodide, methyl iodide, etc. to get what, aromatic ethers. So this about what, Williamson's ether synthesis. This is about how to prepare what, ethers by different methods I told, from alcohols by what, Williamson method, and even using Az2O, dry silver oxide. Dry silver oxide and alkyl halides, they can form ROR. Means again, simple ether is obtained from dry silver oxide. If it is moist silver oxide, then that can form ROH, there is alcohol. But this I told in haloalkane topic only, haloalkanes, okay. Next, properties, there is a physical properties. Physical properties. Physical property, chemical property, these are most common in what, organic reactions. Now, first, physical property, physical state of the compound. Second, solubility. Third, boiling points. Physical state, solubility, boiling point. Diethyl ether, dimethyl ether, they're almost what, highly volatile compounds, maybe in the form of gas, but they can be easily condensed to form liquid. Means at lower temperature, they are in the form of liquid, even at 35 degree, 33 degree, 37 degree, means normal body temperature. At that temperature also, they are in the form of gas. Hence, you have to say dimethyl ether, diethyl ether, they are colorless gases. And higher members, propyl, butyl, pentyl, long chain ethers, they are colorless liquids with a characteristic smell or pleasant odor. Okay. Then about solubility. These behave like alcohols. Solubility of alcohol in water, yes, they are soluble. Due to hydrogen bonding, I told, their hydrogen bonding. But for all ethers, you see here, ethers, ROR, ether. If R group is small, methyl, methyl, ethyl, ethyl, propyl, butyl, not allowed. If R group increases, size of the R group increases, then they prevent formation of hydrogen bond with water. S2O, S2O. Ethers can form hydrogen bonding with water, but only lower ether, methyl, ethyl groups. But if carbon chain increases at alkyl group, then this bond, there is a hydrogen bond prevented. Formation of hydrogen bond is prevented. Therefore, higher ethers, they are what, insoluble in water, but lower ethers soluble in water due to hydrogen bonding, due to hydrogen bonding. Next, carbon oxygen carbon bond in ethers, C dash O. So dipole moment. There is a net dipole moment, a resultant dipole moment. Hence, it is said to be polar molecule. But polarity is less, let it be. But it is a polar solvent because it contains polar bond. CO bond in ethers is a polar bond. And ethers act as Lewis base. Because of lone pair on oxygen, yes, ethers, they behave as Lewis bases. Means they can donate electron pair to other species. Hence, it is said to be Lewis base. Then, the solubility in water due to hydrogen bonding. If it is insoluble, then you can say they cannot form hydrogen bond. Okay. Next. About boiling points. C5H11. C5H11 or H12. C5H12 is normal pentane. C4H10O diethyl ether. Diethyl ether. Next. Alcohol C3H7OH. Now see the what? Ether and pentane. Number of carbon 5, 12 into 5, 60 plus 12, 72. Molecular weight 72. 12 into 4, 58 plus 16. 74. Next, butyl alcohol you can take. If it is butyl, what happened? C4, 48 plus 8, 56, 72. Yes, alcohol, ether, and alkane means hydrocarbon with identical molecular masses. Here, molecular mass. If molecular masses are same, they should have same boiling points. But here, all these have different boiling points. But boiling point of these two almost 35 degrees Celsius. Almost same, these two values. Maybe differ by 0.5, 0.3 degrees Celsius. But boiling point of alcohol, this one, 127 degrees Celsius. Now compare this one. So why it is having a very high value compared to this one? About three times this value is more. So it's O dash C, ether. Alcohol, OH, alcohol. Alcohol to alcohol, alcohol to alcohol, there is hydrogen bonding. Ether to ether. Yes, any hydrogen bond? Not possible. Means two ether molecules, they are not held by hydrogen bonding. Maybe what? A weak dipole-dipole interactions. Very weak. Or van der Waals forces. We can say van der Waals forces are weak dipole-dipole interactions. But weak forces are there in ether. Weakest in what? Hydrocarbon, there is a van der Waals forces observed in hydrocarbons. But this one, weak force, strong force, that is called hydrogen bonding. Therefore, ethers have lower boiling point when it is compared to alcohol, aldehyde, ketone, and hydrocarbons with identical molecular masses. Anyway, the boiling point of ethers less than alcohol or others, yes, answer is they do not have hydrogen bonding. They cannot form hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding absent in case of what? Ethers. But hydrogen bonding is there in alcohol. And dipole-dipole interactions are there in aldehyde ketones. Okay. And van der Waals force is there in what? Hydrocarbon series. Okay. Maybe alkane, hydrocarbon series. So this is regarding what? Boiling points. And other points I told, if it is branched molecule, binding point is less. Straight chain molecule, binding point is more. All these are covered in the previous videos. Okay. This regarding physical properties of what? Ethers. Next. Wait. Okay. Then now, chemical properties. Chemical properties of ethers. Chemical properties. Now, consider ether molecule. This is called diethyl ether. See how it can undergo reaction, different types of reactions. Reactions involving CO bond cleavage, reactions involving CH bond cleavage, then reactions involving both CO bond cleavage and reaction involving electron pair. All these reactions are possible, but when you compare the reactivity with others, yes, they are very chemically inert. Means they are less reactive because there is no active function group. ROR group is not said to be active group because O is linked with carbon carbon, not H. If it is O dash H, yes, easily that bond can be broken. But here C dash O dash C. Hence it is said to be not said to be active function group. Hence, it is a chemically inert, but it can be made to react with some special reagents like strong reducing agents, concentrated acids, dilute acids. Means acid or strong reducing agent, they can react. Means only active compounds can react with ether because ethers are chemically inert. Only few reactions we can study. Okay. Now, see here, if it is sulfuric acid, H, SO4 minus plus. Okay, electron pair adds to H plus. Okay, if S plus and electron pair added, then bond is formed. Now it become plus. Now it is oxonium salt. Concentrated sulfuric acid or concentrated acid can form oxonium salt with ethers. It may be HCl or H2SO4. If it is concentrated, then we get oxonium salt. If it is dilute condition, see what happened. Dilute condition. Both side bond break. Dilute condition. HOH. OH here, H here. Then we get CH3CH2OH, CH3CH2OH. Dilute sulfuric acid can form alcohol. ROH, ROH. Means CO bond break. This is the dilute sulfuric acid. Next, using PCl5, yes, this can form CH3CH2Cl, CH3CH2Cl, and this oxygen enters here, gives POCl3. There is PCl5 reaction in Helorkin chapter. There I told PCl5 reaction, same type, POCl3, and RCl, RCl is formed. Yes, this is also possible. Next, chlorine dark. Yes, sir. In the absence of light, yes, only one H replaced by Cl. Only one H replaced by Cl. Dichloroether is formed. If it is chlorine dark, but same type, in place of light and heat, then all the H atoms are replaced by Cl only. Then it is called perchloroether. There is said to be perchloroether. But all these reactions are not there in the syllabus. But you may get in competitive exams. You can answer if it is action of light with chlorine, all H atoms can be replaced. Without light, then only one alpha H can be, alpha dash H can be replaced by Cl. Okay. Then one important reaction in this topic, that is called hydrogen iodide reaction, because Hi is said to be strongest reducing agent, and it can react with, even it is a chemical inert, it can react with ethers to give different compounds. With hydrogen iodide, with HI. See here how HI can react with ethers we can study. Okay. R O R dash plus HI, cold condition, concentrated medium. There is a reactivity of HI with ether depend upon temperature. Here I written cold. If it is hot condition, nature of reaction different. Okay. If it is cold condition, see how it react. But HI, the bond in HI, it is a weak bond. It can be easily broken. And a nucleophile is formed. This is called a nucleophile. And this nucleophile attacks on the R plus. And here negative, negative, positive, positive. And this I minus can attack on R dash or R, anywhere it can go, but it attacks on R, attacks on R group. But here cold condition, then H and RO, ROH means alcohol and R dash I, we get ROH R dash I. Alcohol plus alkyl iodide, both are formed. If one mole of HI is used, and cold condition, usually in cold condition, one mole of HI, hot condition, two mole of HI. But in exam, they are not giving sometimes cold and hot, they are giving two mole of HI. That shows, yes, in the hot condition only. One mole of HI, cold condition. Okay. If it is cold condition, yes, we get one mole of alcohol and one mole of alkyl iodide. See the mechanism. CH3OCS3 hydrogen iodide. But electron pair in case of ether behave as Lewis base. Hence they can donate electron pair to hydrogen ion. Now it is protonated to get CS3OH CS3 plus I minus. Now it is called protonated ether, or oxonium ion is formed. Oxonium ion. Next you see bond, CO bond, CO bond. Both are same. And O plus can attract bond towards itself. Then bond, there is a heterolytic fission occur. Next we get CS3OH, and this after breaking, now this become positive, this become negative, negative positive neutral, and positive negative combined to give what? CS3OH plus CS3I. But actually in the mechanism what I told, first H plus adds to O. Means O act as a Lewis base and forming oxonium ion. And further it lose what? Methyl plus or methyl carbocation, but it is unstable. But methyl plus can combine with I minus, or I minus attacks on the C plus, that is called nucleophilic substitution reaction. Again, it is said to be nucleophilic substitution reaction. But if it is small group, methyl group is small group, then it is said to be undergoing SN2 mechanism. It is said to be undergoing SN2 mechanism, SN1, SN2. But this is also one of the important reaction, and I will repeat this concept in the next video. And one more concept is there, electrophilic substitution reaction using what? Anisole. That also will cover. Okay.